So today we're going to walk you guys through how we design and pre-manufacture all of our roof components. So this specific roof we're building, it's a single pitch shed roof. It also has decorative rafter details. We've divided this roof into five individual components that meet the restrictions of transportation. So once the trusses show up in our facility, we'll take them over at our production table to start building one individual component. We start by placing the trusses upside down, and then we'll attach all of our OSB sheathing. So this OSB sheathing acts as our air barrier. This is the bottom of the truss, so which will ultimately be the ceiling of the house. So we detail all the seams with a high performance Siga tape. And then after this component is landed on site, we'll be building a utility cavity on the inside of that that'll allow all of our mechanical systems to run through. So once we finish attaching all of our OSB sheathing and tape all of our seams, we'll then flip this truss over and be ready to insulate. So here you'll see one of our roof components that's flipped right side up. At this point, we're ready to insulate. How we insulate these, we blow in cellulose. On this specific project, we're doing about 20 inches, which gives it a roughly an R70 roof. So once it's insulated, we're then ready to apply our roof sheathing. We're using 5/8 plywood, and after that, we'll then install our peel and stick membrane, which makes it watertight. So once this whole roof component is landed, all you have to do is detail each seam and it'll be waterproof and ready for the roofing material. On this project, we're doing decorative rafter details. We're using BC fir, and we did a slight rabbet, which is the thickness of our soffit. So basically, once these are landed all in place, they're then ready to slide in all of our tongue and groove, which will then make up the soffit on site after the fact. So once we land our walls, we're then ready to land our roof components. And the exterior of our roof components are flush to the exterior wall. So we are actually applying our weather barrier and our strapping to the outside of this, which then should line up on the same plane as our walls. Then it's ready for the facade.